Thank you very much, Dr. Engineer Mohammed. First of all, let me say I'm very grateful to be invited to this platform, the seventh edition of the MEC Foundation. I'm very grateful to the First Lady of Zambia for inviting us. Let me just say I'm the Minister of Information, Publicity and Broadcasting Services in Zimbabwe, and our job in terms of response to the COVID-19 in the country has been, I'm actually the chairperson of the risk communication and information, which has been the vital thing in terms of informing the whole people of this country without leaving anybody behind. So we have put structures all the way to the ward level to make sure all our people are aware of the protocols which have been put together by the World Health Organization and also our government. Our president, as soon as COVID-19 was declared, our president declared it a national disaster, and he didn't spend time in putting together an interministerial task force, where I'm now the spokesperson as the minister who is in charge of making sure that we educate our people, inform them. I'm also happy to say we have done well in that line. All our people now are aware of those protocols. And again, we still have problems. People are not adhering to all the protocols. It also comes as no surprise that women stand at the front lines of the COVID-19 risks, the crisis. You know, women are healthcare workers, caregivers, innovators, community organizers. So we are doing a lot of work to make sure that our women are aware of all the preventative and precautionary measures. In terms of the crisis which COVID-19 has caused to our country, especially with the lockdown, our children who have always been going to school, it has become a crisis in the fact that not all our children were able to go on e-learning. And as a government, we have actually put a lot of resources to make sure that all our schools, at least even in the rural areas, also needs to have electricity. We need to have the gadgets, that is the laptops, desktops, even smartphones, to make sure that all our children, without leaving anybody behind, also gets on e-learning. It has been very clear that children in the urban areas who have got electricity, who have connectivity, and who also have access to computers have been able to continue with their education on e-learning. But as a country and as a government, we can't afford to leave behind the biggest percentage of our children who are in the rural areas. So monies are being put together to make sure that all schools do have electricity out there. Those who are not on national grid in terms of electricity, we can actually bring in investors into the renewable energy, which is solar. And we know that as Africa, we enjoy sunlight for more than 8 hours a day. So once we have all our schools on renewable energy, we have also started producing computers in the country locally, so that they will be affordable for most of the schools. And connectivity, our ICT ministry is all out there to make sure that transmitters are all set out there in the rural areas to make sure our children go to school. This is a problem of also digitalization. We need to come to finish the digitalization. ITU demands that we move from analog to digitalization. And we have found that countries which have finalized digitalization, they've moved with speed in terms of recovery. There has been ravages, crisis economically, and as I said, our children. So digitalization is an issue which we need to finalize as a country. And I'm happy that our country has put in the National Development Strategy 1, which is our blueprint as a country, resources are being put to make sure that we finalize on digitalization so that we can move with speed to counter these economic ravages caused by COVID-19. I wish I had more time to talk about what we have done, but I also want to inform that it is critical to just know that majorities of countries that have been more successful in stemming the tide of the COVID-19 pandemic are actually led by women. And I wanted to just tell you that in Zimbabwe, the Interministerial Task Force, which is led by women, the Minister of Defense, who is a woman, she is actually the chairperson of that committee, which is responding to COVID-19, and the national coordinator of COVID-19 in the country is a Dr. Agnes Mahomva, again a woman, and I've just told you that I am the woman who is in charge of the risk communication and information. So we will continue to work, and we know a lot of work has been done by the Ministry of Gender, and our Minister Dr. Nyoni is also in this meeting. A lot of work has been done to make sure that we stem the tide of COVID-19. It is difficult. It is a new normal. Our people continue to be need to be told to adhere to these COVID-19 protocols. You know, it is not easy to change people's attitudes, but we continue to talk to them through all radio, television, and everywhere. I thank you, and thank you for giving me this opportunity to share the experiences in Zimbabwe. I thank you.